I'm Kadeen, content creator, TV host, and podcaster.
That's right, and I'm DeVal, former NFL athlete and current film and TV star.
And together, we have four boys.
For better or for worse, we love taking them everywhere.
I am multi, my whole body is multi.
Racism is safety.
This is the Ellis Family Vacation.
So usually when we travel, we like to challenge each other. But on this very special episode of the Ellis' Family Vacation, we visit Birmingham, Alabama, which was a hotbed of controversy during the Civil Rights Movement in the U.S.
And rather than challenge each other, we want to challenge you guys, our audience, not to get emotional as we visit historical museums, monuments, and locations that helped change the face of this country as we pay homage to the people and organizations that helped end segregation in America. Welcome to Birmingham. Deep in the heart of the American South, this Alabama city was founded in 1871. Birmingham is rich with American history, both triumphs and tragedies. And we're here to soak it all in. In the decades after the Civil War, Birmingham became the Iron City, America's leading producer of iron and steel. And because of its metal might, Vulcan, the god of fire and forge, became the symbol of Birmingham.
You think we can get up there?
Yeah, we're going up there to conquer the statue, because that's what we do. Conquer statues, baby.
Let's go up there.
Let me see a statue pose, Jax.
that's your statue pose?
Cassie, where's your statue pose?
What's the Ellis Man statue pose? Dogs gotta eat.
Dogs gotta eat.
Dogs gotta eat.
Dogs gotta eat.
All right, let's rock.
Yeah. So we started at Vulcan Park. Yeah. Which was a cute little spot. And then once you go inside, you can take a look through just the history of the coal mines, the iron industry.
We're able to take our kids and walk them through a textbook.
So what was happening during this time?
Segregation.
There you go.
There you go.
Segregation. This is important for you guys to understand, like, the history of the country and why things are the way they are. The more you know, you can stop it from repeating itself.
There you go.
Right?
It's amazing to see how much the kids actually absorbed after being at these places.
The big statue of Vulcan, 56 feet.
Mm-hmm.
It was first made in 1904, was it?
Yeah, there you go, 1904, there you go. Stop, stop. First of all, what is this? A leg. Why is the leg by the head, bro?
I'm good at art. I could draw, I could paint.
Bang, look at that. What is this piece right here? That's a shoulder. What is this?
I don't know what that is.
I don't even know what this is.
Somebody stole some of the pieces from the Vulcan, because this ain't working out right. This is throwing a rock. This is throwing a rock.
Once we finally got to the top where the statue was, it's a beautiful view of Birmingham.
Look, guys, we walked all the way through there. See
that?
We walked all the way down there. It would be dope if we had like a zip line and we could just zip line straight back to the car.
Okay.
It's time to eat?
Time to eat.
We went to a great place called Yo Mama's.
Oh, Yo Mama's.
I had the fried catfish.
I'm still thinking about it.
Hey, bro, we trying to do an interview, man. We sat down with Denise.
Oh, yes.
Denise has family recipes passed down.
I changed up some of them, like the meatloaf. We had regular meatloaf, and now I do bacon wrap meatloaf. So,
okay,
yeah, so I kind of add a little
she
bit to
little
it.
Jazz, the recipes.
Right,
like
and okay. So what people expect when they come to Yo Mama's,
gotcha.
It came from my mama.
I love that. Yep. I see the food is coming out here. My husband's trying to decipher who has what.
Right.
Let me go eat my chicken and waffles before he tries to eat my share.
All right?
All right.
That's good.
That's a waffle.
God,
all of it is different.
That food what? Slap. One more time. That food what? Slap.
That's our thing. If the food is good, the food is going what? Slap. Denise, baby. Keep it up, sis.
Hey, welcome to Rickwood Field, guys. This is America's oldest baseball park.
That's part of the reason why we chose it.
We're also the last baseball park that the Negro Leagues considered a home field.
Birmingham Black Barons played here in the early to mid-1900s when the baseball leagues were segregated. The Black Barons were so good that many times they drew larger crowds and more press coverage than their white counterparts. Dang.
Wow, guys.
You see that feeling?
See that feeling?
There were people who looked just like us who couldn't play in the major leagues. And now look, y'all able to do whatever you want, right?
Yes.
Because people thought bigger, right? Mm-hmm. That's our goal for our whole life. Just think bigger.
Think bigger and do bigger, right?
Yep. Oh!
What you got?
Woo! Let me see if I can hit this at least past second base. Oh! Ah! Oh, that was it! Oh!
Oh, wow.
Wow!
This your workout for the day, huh? Oh, nice.
And I'm gonna retire on that.
Thank you.
I'm gonna retire on that.
I wanna throw it.
Oh, whoa.
Is that a bad throw?
You trying to beam my batter. All right, let me see. Eyes on the ball. Hey, use your hips, you good.
Feet still.
Eyes on the ball. Eyes up, there you go, focus. Hey, focus.
But I can't hit it though.
You can, yeah. Relax. It just takes a minute. Okay. Hey, relax.
Hands together.
Hey, come here. You're so hard on yourself, bro, come here. You're so hard on yourself. Listen, if professional athletes who do this thousands of times a day at best can only hit it 3 out of 10 times, what make you think that on the first time you're gonna hit a home run? You have to have realistic expectations. It's your first day. Mm-hmm. Just relax. Focus on the details, all right? Mm-hmm. So you good, man. Give me some. You disappointed?
Yep.
Listen, disappointment's part of life. If you wanna be better, that means you gotta practice. Greatness earned, not expected.
We saw the locker room, and there was pictures of Reggie Jackson, Babe Ruth.
Willie Mays.
These locker rooms are built to look just like they looked back in the 40s.
As a former pro athlete with guys who may be athletes, may be engineers, it was good for them to see the energy. Okay.
You mean will be.
Will be. There you go. You got to speak it into existence.
Not maybe.
It was good to see where it all started. You know, looking at the first black team, the Black Barons, because when we talk about breaking color barriers and creating a legacy for your family and for your people, it all starts at Rickwood, which is amazing that my children get a chance to hit the ball and run the bases that so many greats that look like them already ran.
The Civil Rights Institute is across the street from the 16th Street Baptist Church, which is the site of one of the darkest moments in the Civil Rights Movement. On Sunday, September 15th, 1963, Ku Klux Klan members bombed and killed 4 young black girls. The bombing became a major turning point in race relations in the United States, ultimately helping garner public support for the Civil Rights Act of 1964.
They got a chance to walk through and see what segregation actually looked like.
So if you were black, you had to go to the front door to pay, of course.
Right.
But then you would have to get off and come to enter through the back door.
Oh, wow.
Some bus drivers would close the door, keep driving.
So your grandparents, my parents, lived through parts of segregation. They've been through it, and look now. We live where we want, we walk where we want, we do what we want to do, right?
Mm-hmm.
Be proud of your history.
It's okay.
It's all right, bro. Look, it's okay. Hey, look at me. You can't be afraid to cry, bro. Look at me, I cry too. But you gotta learn to be strong. If Grandpa can live through this, right, and create a better life for Papa Scoop, who create a better life for me, you can too, right? But don't be afraid to cry, man. That don't make you less of a man. You got it, man?
You know, after everything that we saw, it was just good to have the boys see some fun and some innovation.
Welcome to the largest motorcycle museum in the world.
We learned about motorcycles from as early as 1860s to now over 160 years of innovation here in one space. And they got a chance to see all sorts of things from 3D printing, aerodynamics. We got to see a racetrack in the backyard of the museum where Porsches were racing around over 100 miles per hour.
Yeah, it was pretty cool.
It was, and the place is pristine. Like, when you see the details of Barber's Motorsports, you will realize what details can do for a place. This place is amazing.
And what not touching the motorcycles will do. Because Miss Mary was like, please refrain from touching the motorcycle.
Please don't touch.
Don't touch. As Kyra was like,
please don't touch. Please don't touch.
You can get it like you want it. Yeah, right. Don't touch them.
Okay. Would you come back to Birmingham?
Yes.
Yes.
So you get the Cairo approval, yes. The Cairo stamp of approval.
Who would have knew Birmingham was going to be so much fun?
Yes.
So
Birmingham was so fun.